Hello everyone, this is Jozef Notch here, and in this video I'm going to show you how to install OpenFOAM. Now this is not really a tutorial, more like a quick tip. The goals are the following. I want you to have a rough idea how to install OpenFOAM and ParaView by the end of this video. I'm going to show you two possibilities to do this, and I'm going to use Ubuntu 12.04 for that. There are specific reasons and I'll come to that throughout the video. Okay, so now what I assume now here at this point, that you're sitting at home in front of your PC or laptop with Windows on it, and then you ask yourself, how can I download OpenFOAM and how do I run it? Now I have good news and bad news. The bad one is that you need Linux for that, and the good news is that it is very simple to install Ubuntu, and you do not have to get rid of Windows to have Ubuntu. Let me just jump in and show you roughly how to install Ubuntu on your PC. If you go to Ubuntu.com, here you can download Ubuntu and then install it, but there are some points that you have to consider. If I click here on download and then I go to alternative downloads, the point is that OpenFOAM cannot be downloaded with the first alternative that I'm going to show you under the latest release of Ubuntu. I'm recording this video in September 2014, and today it is not possible to download OpenFOAM, the official version of OpenFOAM, under Ubuntu 14.04. This is the reason why I'm using the old version, 12.04, but at first I want to go here to other images and select the nearest mirror. I'm close to Germany, so I click here, and here you find the latest releases, and if you want you can click on the 12.04, 12.12, 13.04, 13.10, or you can just download the latest version of Ubuntu and then jump ahead in the video and take a look at the second alternative to install OpenFOAM. So if I now just click here, then you have to select the correct file to download, and my PC here is a desktop for 64-bit PC, and I want the ISO file, so I would click here and then save link as. I won't do it because I will not reinstall Ubuntu here on this PC. But if you don't have Ubuntu, then click here and download it. And download this file. And how to continue from there? The guys from Ubuntu have a very good tutorial on that, and if I click here, yes, here you can download the latest version, but just download it from this list, and here you have, I assume that you're a Windows user, and here they tell you how to burn a DVD on Windows and how to create a bootable USB stick in order to install Ubuntu. If I take a look at this, how to burn a DVD, you just download this ISO file here, and in Windows 7 or 8 you just right click, burn disk image, and then burn the DVD. And they even have 5 steps for Windows 95 till Vista 7. You can even install Ubuntu from Windows 95, and if you're using Windows 95, I can promise that Ubuntu will be much more user friendly. Good, and then the other alternative is to use a USB device. I believe you have to, yes, the stick has to have at least 2 gigabytes of free space. And then you have to download this pendrive Linux USB installer and browse, find the ISO file, and then create the USB device. And what you do afterwards, you restart your laptop or PC and then boot from the USB or from the DVD. And you have the possibility to install Ubuntu side by side to Windows, so you don't have to get rid of Windows. This is also a possibility. And I am pretty sure that you don't want to delete your Windows. Another possibility is to install Ubuntu in a VirtualBox. You can do that. Look for tutorials on that. I won't show you because I want to actually concentrate on OpenFOAM. And let's just go there. You go to openfoam.org and then you click here on download, or you can click here, and as you see you have the different distributions, and they offer OpenFOAM for these different distributions like Ubuntu, SUSE, Red Hat for example, other distributions. I will download it for Ubuntu because I'm using Ubuntu. And I click here, Ubuntu, and here they have a very, very good description on how to install it. These are 3 or 4 steps if we want to install ParaView also with this command. So what you do, you select these two lines at first, then you open up terminal by clicking here terminal or pressing Ctrl Alt T. And then, because we selected here these two lines, we can press now in the terminal the middle mouse button, and this will copy the selected lines into the terminal. Now I press Enter. For that, I need to insert my password. Good, it worked. And now I go back here, I select this sudo apt-get update, middle mouse button, and it inserted the line. I select this line, and this will install OpenFOAM, the latest version, 2.3. Okay, the update finished, so I selected this line, and I press now my middle mouse button, and now, yes, install these packages without verification. Yes, please install it. Y and enter. And now OpenFOAM will be downloaded and installed. This might take a while, so I stop recording now and I come back once the installation finished. Okay, so my installation finished. It was very fast. Yours might be a little bit slower. But once you have these lines here at the end, everything went fine. And what you have to do is you select this. It says to use OpenFOAM, please add this line to your bash RC. Now, how do you do that? You again select this line here. And now we open up. Or bash RC, for that I will click the terminal, and now we open bash RC. You can do it externally in gedit for example, but I will do it here in the terminal with the text editor in the terminal, and I will use nano for that. So I type in nano space and then dot bash RC and press enter. Here you cannot use the mouse, so you have to use the arrow keys. I go down to the very end. I selected the one line and I press now the middle mouse button. It copies that one line into this file, into this text file. Now I save this by pressing Control O and enter. And now I exit the text file with Control X. Now I have to source this again, but the easiest way is just to close the terminal and open up a new one, like pressing Control Alt T. Now we have OpenFOAM installed. Now in order to install ParaView, I could just copy this line and then paste it with the middle mouse button here into the terminal, but I want to show you another possibility. Usually what I do, I go to paraview.org and I download the latest version from here. I will now, here you can choose the version. I will download now the latest stable version, and my PC is a 64-bit PC, and I will download the tar file. So now I press download and yes, download it please, and now it will download ParaView. This will take a while, so I will stop recording now and I come back when it finishes. Okay, the download is now completed. So what I will do now, I will go to the terminal. I will move the tar file out of the downloads into my home. I do this with the command mv space and then downloads and then the file. And if you don't know how to do this and you don't want to type in ParaView minus 4.1.0, then it's very easy. Again, so mv space and then you type in dow and then you press tab, then this will fill in the rest of the word, and then you type in pa and then tab, and then it will fill in the rest of the file name. And I will move this file. I pressed space and now dot and I press enter. Now it moved the file out of downloads into my home, and now I have to extract it, and I type for that tar xvf and then the file and I press enter. Now it extracts ParaView and now I could just start ParaView by typing ParaView and then use from the bin folder ParaView. Now this will open up ParaView. But if you're lazy and do not want to type in every time this path, then you can just create an alias for the path. For that, I will select this here and open up the bashrc like I did before. nano.bashrc, enter, I go down and I will create an alias like this here. I type in alias and then I want to type in ParaView if I want to open up ParaView, so I type in ParaView and this is equal to the path that we just selected. Good, I save with Control O. Enter, Control X is, I go out, and now I have to source the bashrc, so I will just open up a new terminal. And now if I type in ParaView, this will open up ParaView. Very good. So I showed you how to install OpenFOAM and ParaView. Now I will remove these two installations and I will come back and show you an alternative way. Okay, I removed the two installations and now I will show you an alternative way how to install OpenFOAM. And as I mentioned, today I'm recording this video in September 2014. It is not possible to download the official version of OpenFOAM under Ubuntu 14.04. Maybe at a later time it will be possible, but I show you this second alternative. If you have Ubuntu 14.04, you don't have to downgrade your Ubuntu distribution. And you can use this alternative also in 12.04 and in other Ubuntu versions also. So what you do, you go to the homepage of reallogic.at, and here the guys at Reallogic pre-compiled the latest versions of OpenFOAM. You click on downloads and here you see that they pre-compiled the versions 2.11, 2.2, 2.21, 2.22 and 2.3, and I want to install 2.3 here. Here I take the Ubuntu version 12.04, but it also works for 14.04. I tested it. I click on it. Yes, please save it. And this tar file includes both OpenFOAM and ParaView in one. So yes, this will take a while. So I stop recording now and I come back and the download is completed. Okay, the download is completed now. What I have to do is extract that tar file, and for that I will just open up a terminal. I'm pressing Ctrl Alt T and I will again move the file from downloads into my home and then I extract it like I did before. This will take a little bit longer than with ParaView because this tar file includes both OpenFOAM and ParaView. Okay, and now the file is extracted. What I have to do, I still have to include something into my bash RC, and OpenFOAM is now in my home folder and I have this bash RC minus OpenFOAM minus 2.3. And I open this up, enter, and now I select all these lines here. I press Ctrl X and exit this, and now I will actually open up my bash RC, go to the very bottom, and now I paste it with my middle mouse button. Very good. Now I save it, Ctrl O and then Ctrl X. And again, I have to source it, so I will just open up a new terminal. And now, OpenFOAM is installed. So, if, for example, if I type in SimpleFOAM and press Enter, my Ubuntu recognizes the command. Of course, the case is not set up in my home, so this is why it doesn't work, but the OpenFOAM commands are recognized now by my system, and I can also open up ParaView just by typing in ParaView. Good. So at this point I would like to stop the video. I hope that you enjoyed it and that you learned something. I would like to thank you for watching and I hope to see you next time.